So in today's video, I'm gonna do a super neutral, natural, everyday makeup for beginners, no makeup, makeup tutorial. The brushes I'm gonna be using today are from VP Fashion. These are their new palette makeup brushes. They are 100% cruelty free, and they come with 15 synthetic brushes. They all have these cool little birch wood handles, and the case that they come in is actually made from the shell of a lychee fruit, which I thought was really, really cool and definitely unique. And these brushes, I have been absolutely loving them. They've been very comparable to my Morphe brushes, which is awesome. And for you guys today, I do have a special coupon code. You can get these brushes for 70% off. They're literally only like $30, and that's only like $2 a brush. There's even a kabuki brush in here. So if you want to get your hands on these, I will link them below. And I guess go ahead and stay tuned for the video so you guys can see how I use these to create this very nice, well blended, perfect makeup look. Okay, so the first things first, I'm gonna do my foundation. This is the Maybelline Fit Me Matte and Poreless Finish in the shade Porcelain, because I'm super pale. And I'm going to be using the Stippling Foundation Brush from the Palette Makeup Brush Set. So I'm gonna put some on the back of my hand. And I'm gonna use my Gwen Stefani palette for my eyes later. So I'm gonna go ahead and just use that as my mirror as well. This particular Stippling foundation brush is actually meant for powder foundation, but I always prefer to use these when I do the liquid instead of the regular foundation brush. This is the liquid foundation brush that comes in the kit, but I prefer to use the Stippling one instead because I feel like it just really presses the product into the skin rather than just kind of like smearing it around and wiping it around everywhere. I love this foundation so much. It's one of my favorites. Blending down the neck. I like to use more liquidy foundations with brushes and the more thicker foundations with the Beauty Blender, because otherwise the Beauty Blender will suck up a lot of the liquidous foundations. But I don't find that I have that struggle as much with brushes, and this one did a really clean, nice job. Look at that application, that's like flawless. Okay, and next I'm gonna take my Fit Me powder and the Kabuki brush from this palette makeup brush set. These are so soft for being synthetic, and that is amazing, I love that. So I'm just gonna take this powder, and again, Kabuki brushes are usually used with mineral powder, so like loose powder rather than pressed powder. But YOLO. I feel so old when people say YOLO. I feel like, I don't know, I feel like that's not me. I don't think I've ever really said YOLO before. Alright, so there is my powder. I think I'm just going to proceed on to my contour. So I'm going to use the angled contour brush and my Too Faced Milk Chocolate Soleil Bronzer. And I'm just gonna go ahead and do a powder contour today. I also find that powder is sometimes more subtle. Like that, the bottom of the nose, and then the other side. Okay, so next I'm gonna do blush. And I'm just gonna take this big fluffy brush right here from the kit. You can see like how pretty, how soft these are. Do you see how soft that is? So I'm just gonna pop this on my cheekbones. Oh, by the way, I am using the BH Cosmetics Lilac Blush Duo. And I love this duo just for the simple fact that it does have a dark color and a light color. So I'll dip into the dark first, and if I feel like I've gotten too much, then I'll just do some of the light right over top of it, and it kind of just blends together and make it look a lot nicer. Now moving on to highlight, I'm going to be using ColourPop's Hippo, and this is more of a kind of purpley color. It's not necessarily like frosty white. My favorite ColourPop highlighter is Fanny Pack, but it is discontinued and I'm almost out. So I'm just going to go ahead and use Hippo instead. And this, because it's purple tone, it's more of a toned down highlight rather than a super bright white frosty highlight, which I normally wear. So I'm gonna use this one because it's gonna tone it down just a little bit more. And I'm gonna go ahead and use this fancy little fan brush in the makeup brush set. Since I used powder makeup, I'm going to just spritz the brush itself a few times with some Fix Plus and just kind of gently wave this around in the highlight. And I'm just gonna pop on a little bit of highlight on my nose and then just gonna pop some on my cheeks like so. Just ever so slightly dusted on. Sun-kissed and natural. I like to do the Cupid's bow with my finger just because then I have like more control. And temples, just a skosh. And there we go. I guess I'm gonna go ahead and move on to my eyebrows next. So I'm gonna use this angled brush that again is in the brush set and my How to Make Brows Wow kit from Essence. I use the darkest shade in here and I'm not gonna do my brows as like strong or as sharp as I usually do. I'm kind of just like going over them lightly. I'm not gonna do anything too crazy with them because this is gonna be more of a neutral, natural look. Okay, so it'd be something simple like that. Nothing too harsh or crazy. Okay, so you can see that the brows are a little bit more natural and less completely and totally chiseled and shaped like I normally do. Now I'm gonna go ahead and go in with my NYX Tinted Brow Gel. And I'm just going to clean these up a little bit just to make sure that the little hairs stay down and don't go too crazy and wild. All right, so there's my brows. And now I'm gonna go ahead and move on to eyes, and I'm gonna be using the Gwen Stefani Urban Decay palette. I'm actually gonna take this little packing brush right here. It's more of a smudging brush, but I'm gonna use it as a packing brush. I'm gonna take this little shade right here called Baby, and I'm going to pop this all over my lid. And this is really cool because it just like glides right on. I don't know if you guys can see, but literally it just glides on. No Fix Plus, no nothing. I love this palette so much. And I love these palette brushes. And this fluffy brush right here, I am absolutely loving. It is basically like a MAC 224. Let me grab it really quick. So this brush right here, this one right here, is from the makeup brush set from Vanity Planet. And this one right here is a MAC 224. You can see the MAC 224 is a little bit more fluffy, but this one is very, very, very similar. So if you don't have the money to drop on this brush, you could just buy the whole 15-piece makeup kit and get the brush within it. And now I'm gonna take that blending brush and go in my crease with this shade called Anaheim. And this shade called Zone. I'm kind of going to dip into each one. And I'm just going to go right in my little crease area. And if you are like me and you have hooded eyelids, fake a crease. Just go where your eye socket is and just press down. But do it ever so lightly so it blends out super smooth. And then just keep building it up however dark you want. So if I want to build up a little bit more, I just take that Zone shade, which is the one that is just a skosh darker than the other, and I just kind of blend that into the crease. Okay, easy peasy. Once that's blended, now I'm going to go back in with that original packing brush, and I'm going to take the Anaheim color. I'm going to pop this along my lower lash line. Okay, and then taking the Zone color, gonna go on the outer half of my lower lash line just to kind of give this dimension, just like that. Going in with my ColourPop eyeliner, this one is in the shade Call Me. It is a deep brown. I'm going to just go in my bottom waterline on again just the outer half. I'm not gonna continue it all the way into the inner corner, just staying on the outer half of my eye. And then I'm gonna go ahead and tight line my upper waterline. Just like that. I'm gonna take the color Pop in this palette right here And I'm just gonna take a little bit on one of these smaller brushes. This is more of a concealer brush for like eyebrows or whatever, but I'm just gonna pop this on the inner corner of my eye. Going ahead and using that same brush, I'm gonna take this shade up here called Bathwater right there, and I'm gonna use this as a brow highlight. Okay, and now I'm going to throw on my mascara. So I'm gonna be using the Miss Manga mascara from L'Oreal and popping that just on my bottom and top lashes. And you guys pretty much already know how to apply mascara, so I'm just gonna go ahead and skip this. So I'll see you back in a minute when this is done. Now, completely and totally optional are false lashes. These are my favorite ones to use because they are so wispy and natural and just really, really pretty. I get these in a 5-pack off of eBay for like $1 to $2. I will go ahead and link them in the description box below. So if you guys wanna get your hands on these, you can. And I'm gonna go ahead and apply these off camera and I will be right back. So now I'm just taking my eyelash curler and just carefully blending my real eyelashes to the fake ones. Then I will go ahead and add one more coat of mascara just to the top lashes, just again to blend them all together. Okay, and then for lips, I'm gonna go ahead and use one of my favorite natural, neutral, pinky nude lips. This one is by Revlon and it is in the shade Primrose. And it is kind of comparable to Snob by MAC, except this one is a lot more creamy and satiny and just overall really, really pretty. So I'm gonna go ahead and pop this on my lips. Just like so. Okay, and that is it for my no makeup makeup tutorial, makeup for beginners, everyday makeup look. Definitely feel free to check out these brushes. I will link them in the description box and do not forget to use the coupon code BEAUTY314 because you can get them 70% off, which is crazy insane. I love these brushes. These are a super great alternative to the Morphe brushes that I use on the daily basis. I was super shocked. I didn't even use an eye primer or anything and it blended super nicely. So yay! With that being said, I hope you all enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. And if you decide to recreate this look, be sure and tweet it to me at Amanda314109 so I can see all of your gorgeous faces. And with that being said, I will talk to you all in my next video. So until then, so long, stay strong, stay true, and be you. All right, bye!